everyone, Ian here, and behind me is a new listing for a 2015 Cutwater 30. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this amazing powerboat has to offer. Here we are taking a look at the Cutwater 30. It's currently located in San Diego, California at Southwestern Yacht Club. While we're starting here at the bow, I just want to show you this Bruce style anchor with roller attachment here. This really sets it off nicely, allowing you to anchor the boat with ease and not having to worry about hitting the bow. There's also that extra stainless steel guards up front. We also have a forward bow ladder, so if you beach the boat, you're able to walk up here, open up this quick pin, and be able to deploy the ladder to be able to walk out in front. Really, really nice. Electric windlass by Lumar, and you can tell like all of the stainless is carried really far aft, giving you a really nice secure area up front. And not to mention, there's also a really cool built-in seat up forward as well too. It has a blue painted hull, a red cove stripe down below, and again, the Cutwaters are very, very innovative. They have an innovative hull design and really are packed with so many features. Forward fusion speakers up underneath this eyebrow here, windshield wipers on both starboard and port side, side opening ports, and as you can see up top, we have our spotlight, air horn, Garmin radar. There is an antenna dome up there as well too, along with VHF whip and solar panels, and this really high-end stainless structure up top, so you could attach other items like kayaks and stand-up paddle boards. It's very, very useful. The other thing which I really like, which is kind of trick, is this little extra thought. So this gives you a little extra space here. So walking up, you have footing up to the foredeck, and I'll show you how nice and easy that is. Grab handle here. And again, this extra footing gives you a nice area, great handholds all the way up to the bow of the vessel, where you can gain access here to these really cool trick. Just again, everything's innovative. These are, areas that come out, turn into seats right here. I mean, the vessel itself is truly like a transformer. It really utilizes every inch of space. Lots of, deck space up here. And again, this gives you a nice perspective up on top of the roof here, just how the equipment is set up, opening hatches, lots of light, great ventilation. Again, it's just very, very well thought out. So as we're making our way back aft, you can see what's really unique about this particular model. This has the second steering station. So depending if you're fishing, docking, what have you, you have a throttle, steering wheel, engine controls here, which is really, really nice. So I've left this one kind of in line and kind of stowed, put away, but this side area opens up as a seat, as you see on the port side. So again, just so much thought and engineering went into this particular vessel, and they've done a great job. We have a boarding ladder here, so swim ladder that drops down into the water. Access here, a really nice swim platform here where this owner stows his inflatable kayak. And then you can see the little bumpers here off the back that are built in. This is a propane locker here. This seat also flips around. So there are covers for this, but it flips around so you can face aft if you so desire, or face into the aft cockpit. It's very, very impressive. We have a cockpit table here that's removable. We have storage both to starboard and port side. Centrally located is our engine hatch. So this lifts up by a push of a button and just gains access to the Volvo engine and the generator. Again, looking at the trim, we have an outboard mount here, cup holders, rod holders. It's just really impressive. Wash down here on this side, emergency bilge pump controls there, Fusion stereo speakers. We have the Fusion stereo remote here. The main one is up in the forward stateroom, but this gives you the ability to control the speakers, volume, zones. I mean, look at these built-in high-end stainless steel cup holders here. really, really impressive. Little wet bar, which I like here. So just gives you just nice accessibility here. And then a little refrigerator, small freezer compartment there. Little step ladder. So if you're gaining access up to this hatch, you're able to step down. And then what I really find impressive is just how everything is all labeled, all of the battery switches for the stern thruster, bow thruster, house battery bank, engine bank, generator, that's all located right there. Now, as we come into the vessel itself, this owner has chosen to go with the isinglass or polycarbonate type windows here in the back. These will roll up, as you can see that I've done here, gaining you access, but you can close it off, but still have that light and visibility. We have the galley off to the port side. This is a fridge, small freezer compartment here, extended galley countertop. Now, this wood piece will, you know, fold down and cover the two burner Kenyan electric stovetop and sink to gain additional countertop space if so desired. But you have tons of storage down below here. And then again, this is really a trick about how this seat works. You know, this can, you know, collapse up and give you a bench seating here. So it's very, very versatile in what it does. Also fold down. This wood piece will come down and close this off, so you have all of this countertop space if so desired. When we're inside this boat, overhead opening hatches, we have LED lighting, two Fusion stereo speakers here. Off to the starboard side is this really nice dinette area. Again, the forward helm seat can twist and fold, so you have bench seating all around. And then going into the aft cabin, that this owner uses as storage, but you have access right down here to a nice aft cabin. We have our Cummins Onan generator control switch, Pro Mariner. We have air conditioning, heating controls, our remote meter right there showing you the voltage, our water tank indicator, 12-volt 110 breakers, and ship to shore for generator and shore power. So again, this is really well thought out, well designed, and it's just very versatile in a boat. Table will also come down, so you can transform this into additional sleeping if so desired. But as you can see now, we have the table up, and the seat kind of moved to the captain's position. Before I get too far, extending the galley between this sink, nice Corian countertops. We have a microwave, additional storage down here, and then this cute little Dometic wine fridge underneath the helmsman's. Now coming up to the helm, as you can see, the seat is in the upright position. There are really nice you know, steps that allow you to gain access, have great footing. We have our Garmin VHF 200 here, all of our switches for our windshield wiper, bilge pumps, and what have you, two really nice large Garmin 7212 GPS map displays. So you have two of those. We also have centrally located the Volvo Penta display showing 453 engine hours. I believe there's 60.4 on the generator, a Garmin multi-repeater here. This is a great thing. So this is your controls. This is a remote switch to your stern and bow thruster. So if you're single-handing this boat, this will allow you to operate the thrusters by a touch of a button. So it really gives you that nice comfort and ease of single-handing this boat. And then while you're here at the helm, you have your joysticks for your stern and bow thruster control. So literally, you can make this boat go sideways. You could twist it in a 360 position. There's just so much you can do. So it kind of takes that single screw, you know, kind of fear of docking maneuvering, and it gives you these options, which is really, really impressive in my mind. Throttle controls here. This is our trim tab controls. And the spotlight control, we have a little 12-volt outlet here. There's also a diesel heater. So this will allow you to switch on and off the diesel heater. And then you have your ignition start stop power switch display here. You also have a windlass remote, so you can actually deploy and retrieve your windlass here. Docking lights, nav lights, and what have you. So so much packed into this vessel that you'll see on most 50 foot plus yachts. And again, what I love about it is just the versatility and the engineering and the design that goes into it. Four opening hatches overhead. We have a TV with built-in DVD player that will pivot down. So if you're here in the salon, you can enjoy that if so desired. And again, it's just really well thought out. Now we're going to go down into the main cabin. You do have this companionway door that closes this off, but coming down into the main cabin, you have this really nice bed, kind of angled a little bit here, so you have really good access. It's not like packed in there, so you're sleeping with your heads here, your feet down. They've really done a nice job utilizing the space here. And as we come down into the vessel, you're going to see we have two overhead opening hatches and five opening side ports. There's so much ventilation that will flood this forward cabin. It's really impressive. Not to mention, you have the air conditioning and heating controls, you know, so there's your vent right here. We have a flat screen television that's built in, a really nice kind of cubby storage here that has a little drape that will close this off, storage down below it. Underneath the bed, this lifts up. You have additional storage here. As we move our way to the starboard side, we have a little tilt-up cabinet. This kind of folds down, so you kind of get like a little night table. Locks up into place so you can utilize this. You have access right here to the side of the bed. Here's your heating, air conditioning controls here. Again, lots of storage everywhere and a really nice, comfortable mattress that they've done. 110, 12 volt outlets on the side of the bed. We have lighting above here for reading lights. And I can't imagine what else they could think. You do have a drape, so if you don't want to close off that door, you can have the drape that will cover that, so you do have privacy. And then now let's check out the head and shower compartment. So the head and shower compartment is pretty impressive. Again, goes with the styling and engineer. You have this plexiglass door that will encompass the shower, so when you're in it, you can close off the shower to keep the head and sink area dry. This is an electric freshwater Tecma head, so it's a push of a button and it flushes the toilet. You have two opening hatches in here for ventilation. Really nice, beautiful bowl sink here, fixtures, faucets, a little, kind of a makeup mirror, if you so desire. 110 outlets here, and again, a good size shower. So when you're inside the shower, you close the plexiglass doors, it covers the door area, it'll encompass this area so everything else stays dry. But again, nice space here, and for a 30-foot boat, it's very hard to beat. Also want to point out just the teak and holly flooring that they've done here. Really nice kind of a off-tan gel coat. Light switches here for the cabin. Here's your main Fusion stereo CD player. And again, just tons of natural light that just floods this salon and aft cockpit. Again, ventilation is very, very key, and it is so transformable with all of these options. I mean, just being able to kind of come down, switch your seating around, to have, this all around the dining room table. Again, to be able to flip this backrest, just a push of this button, this folds back. So if this is up, you have aft facing, if you're in Catalina and just enjoying the view, or your kids playing off the back of the boat, there's just so many ways to really enjoy this boat. I hope you found this to be helpful and informative. If you would like more information in regards to this Cutwater 2015, please feel free to contact myself at any time, day or night. Again, my name is Ian Van Tuyl. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.